I'm wearing a very casual outfit today. It's a scarf I got for Christmas. Shout out to Jeff's brother Brad for the scarf. And my Lululemon long sleeve. Ooh, look at that delt. Ooh, I feel like they pop when I get lean. This guy making me late for the movies. So this vlog is going to be on how to survive the movies while on prep.
How to what?
Survive the movies while on prep.
Oh, what are you gonna do?
I peppered meals for today. So I got, maybe I'll wait to show.
Yeah.
I'll wait to show them when there's actually light because we're in the parking garage. Okay, that should be bright enough. Oh, it just stormed again here in Halifax. I don't know what is going on, but all I know is that this time last year, this time last year was just as bad, but like this time when I was growing up and I lived in Halifax my whole life, we had chalk. We would get chalk for Easter. So we would get like toys like skipping ropes and chalk and stuff because it was actually spring. Right now it is winter. Like, I don't know what is going on. It is just completely snowed in. I mean, the roads are plowed, thankfully, but anyway, so back to my meals. Jeff actually helped me with this one. So one of my meals is hash. So that is ground turkey with one hash brown mixed together with my usual spices. And in the shadows, some green beans. So one serving of green beans.
That smells really good.
I know. I love that meal. Ground turkey is like a little fattier than chicken, so it's like kind of a, I don't know, like a special meal for me. And my other meal that I have here, it's like a little snack meal. So this one I'll probably eat when I get to my sister's because I'll need to eat by then. So it is chicken, like only 50 grams of chicken, some grape tomatoes, and some blackberries. I know it's random, but I didn't have much in the fridge and I had to throw a couple meals together before we left. Thin Stations, 100 calorie snack packs. The chocolatey pretzels are my favorite. I love chocolate covered pretzels. The ones, the rolled gold ones that are worth over 1,000 calories per bag, may or may not have eaten a full bag of those in one sitting in my off season. Don't judge me. And I have something else. Oh, I have 20 grams. I know it looks really poverty, but it's because they're all crushed up because it was the last of the bag. But these are 20 grams of the Balsamic Vinegar Pepperidge Farm Cracker Chips. And it's only 90 calories per serving. Normally I'll have them with a Laughing Cow, but I might just want to snack on those in the movie theater. So we're running back to Shoppers just so that I can get my nephews. We're gonna be gone for Easter because we're going to powerlifting nationals in Newfoundland, and my sister has two boys and they're younger, One's 4 and one is 2. So I already got them a few things, but I just wanted to pick them up a few extra things for Easter just so that they can have little baskets from me because I won't be there on Easter. So I want to surprise them now. I'm just gonna pick up a few things. Ooh. Hello, bunny. I think I like that. I'll get 2 of those. One of these from my brother-in-law, my sister's husband. Ooh. The white ones. I can't remember whether my sister likes the white ones. Double milk. Ooh, I think I'll get that one for my sister. She likes milk and white chocolate, I'm pretty sure. Got 2 of those. Don't get stuck. So I'm in Cole Harbor now, and apparently my sister's street is not plowed. But, oh, holy moly. See, I guess when you live in an apartment complex, they have to plow it for you. Where even is her driveway? Got my nephew's Easter basket here. I'm just gonna take a video of it now because they're probably gonna destroy it as soon as they see it. So I got a couple books for them because they love reading and they love cars, and that's a planes book and a little Easter book for the 2-year-old, and Fluffy Lammy, and a little Easter cup thing, and a couple bunnies, and then a couple treats for my sister. What is it?
Cars!
Cars? No, that's planes!
No.
Yes, no, I think it's cards. Planes.
They're cards.
Oh, cards. Yeah, they're cards. They're cards with planes on them. You got a bottle. Cup. So I'm gonna eat this now. Chicken and tomatoes and blackberries. I'm just eating this so that I'll be like semi-full for the movie. Well, I won't get like a low blood sugar attack. And then I won't feel compelled to eat something that's not gonna hit my macros. Hey guys, so I'm on the way to the movie theater now. I'm driving in a separate car because I have to leave to work after this. I just wanted to say that I am not, like, I'm a flexible dieter, so I wouldn't normally pack like those bro meals and eat like a chicken and broccoli in a movie theater. But it just so happens that now, because I'm so late in my prep and I'm kind of in the depletion stages, like I need to be 103 in 10 days and I'm 106 now. So obviously, like, that's a crash diet at this point. Well, I'm not going to just cut it as fat. That's not what I plan to do. It's probably better to just get down to, like, I'm hoping like between 105 and 106, just maintain that and then do a little water cut, because that's probably going to be what's going to make me feel the strongest on meat day, because I can just drink a whole bunch of water and just replenish right after weigh-ins. It's a 2-hour weigh-in, by the way, so it's not as straightforward as the 24-hour weigh-ins, because you can do whatever means necessary to get to your weight and then just like completely recover from it. Like, it's not that way with the IPF, that like the league that I compete in. But anyway, so normally I wouldn't, like, if I was 10 weeks out or 14 weeks out or something and I had plenty of time, my macros were good, then I would like have no problem eating popcorn or like buying a snack at the movie theater. It's just that right now, if I'm not, like, my calories aren't that high. Like, I like to eat a lot of food. They're at 1400, which I know is like, I can't complain honestly being a 100-pound person, but for me, I like have always been a really big eater. So if I'm not eating high volume meals that end up being clean, like lowish fat and like just voluminous meals, then I'll be really hungry, and I have to eat those meals every couple of hours as well. So I'll have a meal with protein every 2 hours or so. Otherwise, I'll start to feel like really faint and like jittery. So that's just what I'm doing right now. This is kind of like a last leg of prep advice on like what to do at the movies. So I suggest eating a low calorie meal with chicken right before, or like with protein right before you go to the movie, so that you don't get there and like crave everything. My cravings really aren't that bad right now, to be honest. I'm going to stop vlogging and driving, and I'll see you guys at the movie theater. Well, it doesn't look like I'm gonna get snacks anyway, because that is the line. Hey guys, so I am back from the movies. The movie was really good. It was really sad though, and I cry during sad movies, so I cried. Zero calorie Jones soda, vanilla bean. You can't get diet anything this year.
Everywhere, freaks and harries, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. The rich feed the poor till they're on their own, reach no more.